vortex. I'm so sorry. That happens a lot. I had the camcorder on the dashboard and it just flew the fuck off because I was going around a turnpike. Okay? I'm sorry. Look, we're not tech savvy, okay? We've never been tech savvy and we have no intention of ever becoming tech savvy. And I don't care how many people are bothered by this. You don't get to tell me how to live my life. I don't smack the phone out of your hand like a true Luddite should. So stop calling me a Luddite. Because I wish that I was. Like, legit. So I was just thinking about things that I could invent that would indicate to drivers in front of me that I'm pleased with their driving. Because there are ways to indicate that I'm displeased. You know, like I can inch up really close, flash my brights at them, I can scream at them, you know, honk. But I can't do anything positive. It seems like we only have messages to indicate our anger, our hostility towards somebody. There's the horn. We need like the opposite of a horn. But what is that? What is that exactly? Anyway. Sorry, I'm really deep in thought right now, pondering. You know, things that should have been invented a long time ago. But yeah, so thinking about my unconventional lifestyle, for those of you who don't know, I don't have a smartphone, I don't believe in social networking, I think that all of that stuff is satanic, I think that it's a form of sorcery, and I think that the sicker people are, the more they want to engage in antisocial behavior, like using a website that has the sole intention of turning everybody's brain into Swiss cheese, okay? There are ways that you can use social media that benefits society, but most people don't do that because most people are not good, okay? And I've seen, like, good people get worse. Like, it's crazy to me how many people will choose that. And I think that they are aware of it, but those that are not aware of it are like, why wouldn't you want to be on Instagram? Why wouldn't you want to have an iPhone? Why wouldn't you watch television? Why wouldn't you see a psychiatrist when you're sad sometimes? I'm sad a lot of the time. I don't need a psychiatrist for that. People need to stop being such fucking pansies, all because they're experiencing something uncomfortable. People need to grow the fuck up. You know? It's like, this is what people do anytime they get bored. Because it's a compulsion. It's like, they're worse than gambling addicts, dude. The majority of society is worse than a gambling addict. Like, I feel like there are way more reasons to be hopeless than, you know, oh, America's over. America should be over. America fucking sucks, dude. This is the worst country in the world. It's always been the worst country in the world. I'm sorry that you believed the lie for so long. Bye-bye, patriot. Goodbye. Go masturbate to that American flag somewhere else, okay? We still have an American flag. Which is dumb. We probably should give it to a patriot. It's like a fad, isn't it? It is a fad. So many things are. Like, the crucifix is a fad. Or the cross. Not really the crucifix, but the cross. But I know several people that wear a cross around their neck. And they're not Christians. Like, they don't even believe in God at all. Well, they have their reasons for wearing it. Like, oh, this friend of mine that died, he believed in Jesus. Well, maybe you should follow his example, because wherever he is a lot better than where you're going to be. I'm just saying. It's like, I never thought that that wasn't real. Like, the whole time that I was behaving as a total heathen and, like, participating in a pagan lifestyle, like, I never once thought that that wasn't, like, gonna be punished. I just feel like this whole, like, living in the moment, like, you just don't care. Like, you train yourself to not care about that. You train yourself to not worry about the consequences of your actions. Well, if abortion isn't the finest example that I could cite of, you know, physical consequences for your actions, I really don't know what would be a better example than that. Because there are so many different arguments you can make about how horrible of a thing abortion truly is. And yet, the same motherfuckers just keep recycling the same talking points because they just don't know what else to do, I guess. Like, everybody's just on the same track of, like, I'm gonna be as boring as possible. I'm gonna... That's right, I use my turn signal. I'm a good person. Sometimes I don't use it. I always feel bad. And, like, then I try to apologize to the person behind me, but I can't do that either. There needs to be an invention. Why don't you work for the tech companies? Because I have too much of a conscience. Same reason why I won't work for the government. Because, you know, I used to want to be a social worker. But, I don't think I could do that. I would be one of those social workers that they would kill. Because I would expose, like, how most of them are pedophiles. Or they're, like, purposely putting kids in the homes of pedophiles. So, I would be one of those Nancy Schaefer types. Saint. Yes, she's a saint. We should strive for saint-like qualifications, okay? That's what everybody should strive for. And I guess that's why I live in poverty. Well, I mean, if you saw the retirement community that my parents are living in, you'd be like, damn, she's made bad decisions. Yeah, they've tried to instill, like, personal responsibility and all that. I think that I have that down when it comes to my mental state, but when it comes to finances, I really, really suck. Like, my friend Brad has been trying to help me out with that. The dude that plays the keys that's actually talented. He's very, very good at keyboard. Like, he's good at everything that he does. Because he's organized. Imagine that. I was watching these videos that I put up last night for myself playing keyboard in my living room. And I think that the reason why I can't, you know, stick with anything... Because I've had a lot of other comedians that are like, you know, you have the potential of, like, a really serious comedian. Like, you could be famous and all that, and you could be a touring comic, and I get that, but it's like they give me the same crap advice that I've received from so many plebeian sheep. Like, why don't you do this, this, and this? Why don't you be just like everybody else? You think I haven't tried? It's like, I've done everything that the sheep do, aside from, like, get married, okay? I haven't gotten married, I haven't had any babies, and you should be grateful for that. And not because having babies is a mistake, but because having babies out of wedlock, when you're not prepared to have a baby, is it as much of a mistake as killing it? Because killing it's horrible. And I feel so bad that we live in a society that allows that and that thinks that that's okay. All because they're reckless and stupid and irresponsible. You know? But there are just so many things that are so messed up about our society. In case you're wondering why I yell so much and why I seem so mean, it's because I just think about how horrific things truly are all the time. And people don't feel anything anymore. Not that they ever did. Maybe they never felt anything. But it's okay, I'll feel it for you. It's good that I'm listening to a blues band. A blues band that was taken over by hedonistic witches that had believed in abortion. But hey, at least they wrote good songs about it, right? Sorry, I don't know why I just started crying. Abortion. Da-da-da-da-da. That's how so many people feel about it. But I don't know. It's like the fact that people have sexual intercourse. Like it ain't shit. You know, that's why they kill a baby like it ain't shit. The whole lifestyle itself, the lifestyle of, like, we can engage in reckless sexual behavior, and it's like, do you have any idea how many stand-up comics talk about eating ass? And they talk about it to fit in. I don't even know if half of them actually do that, okay? I mean, they probably do. But you know, I've done a lot of stupid things in my past. I've made a lot of mistakes. But I don't know. The fact that people, like, they sort of, like, what's the word? I'm trying to think of the word. It's killing me that I can't think of it. Relish. Relish. It's like they relish the fact that they're doing something that's really disgusting. You know? Just like so many people will, you know, wear their psychological problems as some sort of badge of honor. Like, oh, I have depression. I take pills for my depression, and depression's a disease. And I mean, I've heard so many things doing stand-up. I'm really grateful for that experience, by the way. Like, I used to be a flaming liberal, and I've made a lot of bad decisions, so it's not like there's anything that's too much for me to hear, but it's like I was lucky, though, because I had friends. When I was making those bad decisions, I had a lot of friends. They were also making bad decisions, but they were pulling me aside and going, your decisions are really, really bad, Amy. I'm hearing stories about you, and I don't want to hear stories about you. I don't like people talking shit about you, because the way that you're behaving is not you. But I do think that a lot of people, though, probably do what I used to do, where they feel like they're playing a role. They make decisions for other people. Well, I didn't really like who I was at the time. So I drank I drank a fuck ton of liquor in order to be, like, a completely different person. And the person that I became was just, like, a shithead. Like, a total fucking shithead, dude. And I have to live with all of those things. But I guess because, like, I know how bad I can be. I know that I have the potential to be a disgusting, filthy trash ball, okay? I know that I have that in me. Everybody does. And so because I chased the bad, now I'm chasing the good. And this is what I'm talking about when I say that, like, I'll just burst out in tears because I'm totally overwhelmed by God's grace. And I'm totally overwhelmed by the crucifixion. And I really get those three nails. I really get the purpose of that more than I don't. And who's calling me? And why are you calling me? You know I have to work. You know I have to work, whoever you are. Hold on one second, Vortex. I'm so annoyed right now, can you tell? Can you tell how annoyed I am? Type of person that carries like two giant bags and I can never find anything that I need to find. But yeah, I get very overwhelmed by God's grace more times than I don't. And when I think about my past and I want to throw up, it's like, it's okay, Amy. That's why Jesus died on the cross. It's okay. But you know, I know that God wants me to go on stage and talk about Him. He wants me to show that there's another alternative to everything that our society is doing. Yay, we just ran a red light, y'all. We just ran a red light. We didn't like speed through it. That's wrong. That's wrong, and that could get people killed. Don't do that. That's not what I'm encouraging. But if it would be more dangerous for you to slow down and then like hit your brakes really hard, I have a habit of doing that, and then everything goes fine. But, you know, just don't do anything. If you're gonna break the rules, just don't do anything to, like, endanger other people. Because that's not okay. Let's see. Calls. I got to move. I can't stay there no more. I got to move. Dude always calls me when I'm about to go to work. Disappointment with a modern woman. You know, I think about, like, in the 50s, they had all these, like, ads for cleaning products and beauty products. That's what screwed up women. The housewife. Being a wife and a mother should be enough. You know, making your house look good, that shouldn't be anywhere near as important as, like, being a good woman to the people that you're supposed to take care of, you know? And I think I have a much deeper understanding of that than, like, a lot of people. And so their Christianity and their conservatism and their whatever the fuck they want to call it is, like, totally in vain. Oh my goodness, dude.
I told you you had it. I told you you had it.
It's the man in my head.
You really do look like a kid with a missing tooth.
I know. I know. I look like I'm like 8. Or 2. There's this old dude that works here who kept complimenting me about my hat being backwards. He was like, "You look so fucking cute." Okay, dude. Calm down. It's weird how many people find me attractive and like the last thing that I want is sex. It's weird that that's, like, the first thing that people want, and the only thing that people want. And they don't even enjoy it. You know? I've said this before, and I'll say it again. You come, but do you ever really get there? Do you ever get anywhere? You know? It's like anything else, I guess. Like, I don't really understand, like, addiction. And I say that, like, I used to be an alcoholic, but I feel like there's a lot of shit that I was dealing with. But, like, people that are into something because of, like, the dopamine or whatever, like, I don't have the same issue. My dopamine, I have a dopamine machine in my mind. That's why I don't need a television and I don't need to overeat or, have sex or, you know, do any of the things that would give me dopamine. You know, like, I don't get dopamine when I go on stage and I make people laugh. I don't get it when I make people laugh in the real time. I don't, you know. I'm glad that I can. I'm grateful for the fact that God has given me this gift that, allows me to be of service to other people. Like, that's good. But I don't get anything out of it. Like, it's not for me, I guess that's what I'm saying. Like, okay, what was I looking for? Lemon. And then, what else? Yogurt. It's organic, creamy, and dairy-free. Billions of proven probiotics. I don't know about that. Billions? That's so many. That's so many in this little container. I don't believe that shit. I think that's a lie. I think they're like maybe 100 tops. But they're proven. By who? What, the coconut yogurt experts? I need to, like, do some sort of bit or some song or something about the fact that I don't get dopamine at all. Because I do think that that is what motivates a lot of people, is, like, the reward, you know? Well, my reward is in heaven, so I can't get shit from anybody on this planet. But I do think that that's why people are so messed up. It's like, they do things for the purpose of being rewarded by, like, other people in society that are also shitty and do everything for the wrong reason. So it's like, society's just hopeless. That's always the genuine gist of everything that I talk about. But, gotta go to work. I'm already late, but it was fun chit-chatting.
always and forever, Vortex. Love you.